The object of this research is the conservation treatment of the artwork Senza Titolo, a contemporary wooden sculpture made by Marcolino Gandini in 1966. Marcolino Gandini was born in Turin in 1937. He grew up in Torinese intellectual scene and was a student of Felice Casorati. After a first figurative period, he dedicated to abstractism. He participated at numerous international exhibitions. He died in 2012 before the exposition Marco Gandini, Marcolino Gandini, un incontro di vita d'arte. Before the restoration, the Gandini's family has been contacted and Tito Gandini, the son of the artist, has been interviewed, according to Inca's guideline. With the interview, it was possible to know that the colors of the artwork were inspired by nature and the reference was to the perfection of geometry and linearity. The work of artwork was exhibited in 2003 at Sala Bolaffi in Turin, and later it was donated by the artist to the Museum of Modern Art MAGA of Gallarate. After the study of the artist, the composing materials of the artwork and its state of conservation were studied. The support is composed by panels of poplar plywood, beechwood and firwood, and there are numerous inscriptions on the back. The pictorial film is composed by one layer of alkyd preparation and some layers of acrylic vinyl house paint. On the back, there was a visible and extensive attack by Xylophagus insects and some losses of wood. On the front, there were cracks and lacunae, dark marks, losses, incisions, and some fingerprints and deposits. With the aim of preserving artwork's history and its meaning, respectful and recognizable solutions have been designed. After the approval of Gandini's family for the restoration, a diagnostic campaign was performed. The artwork was observed under natural light, red light, wood lamps examination, and infrared and infrared false color photography. Some fragments of pictorial film were observed under a microscope, and on the surface were made the wettability test with water drop and the superficial pH and conductivity test. In addition, the X-ray fluorescence XRF and the Fourier transform infrared spectroscopy were made to identify the binder. With the observation of some fragments under the microscope, it was possible to identify a white first layer of preparation and a brown layer, probably earthinking, under the visible color on the surface. The XRF analysis was useful to compare old color chart of 1981 of Colors Morgan's paint, the line of colors often used by Marcolino Gandini. The color compositions are different, so we can presume that Morgan's paint compositions have been changed from the 60s or that the artist used different colors. A respectful and effective cleaning method was found. For the sensibility of house paints, some samples painted by acrylic and vinyl colors were analyzed. The surfaces of samples have been coated with standard soil of Richard Wolbers. Over the samples were tested many cleaning methods, and then the best method was selected. The best method was obtained using aqueous solutions, pH and conductivity adjusted. The cleaning was carried out with makeup sponges of Kiko, already studied for dry cleaning and moistened with 1 ml of solutions. In this way, the humidity over the surface was controlled and the abrasions and brushing of the superficial pictorial film has been avoided. The chosen solutions are the solution pH 6, 10 millisiemens per centimeter for all the surface. The solution's pH 6, 6 millisiemens with the aqueous of pH 6 for the second pass on the white bands, and the solutions of sodium citrate pH 6, 6 millisiemens for the second pass over yellow bands. All the cleaning process have been monitored under a microscope 40x magnification to ensure the good state of conservation after the treatment. For the aesthetic presentation, has been executed a reversable and recognizable retouching with microcrystalline wax warmed by hand and used for filling lacune and gaps. At the end of the intervention, the artwork Senza Titolo was exposed by Madre Museum of Naples for the exhibition dedicated to Marcello Rumma. The artwork was then returned to Maga Museum, which was given some instruction on preserving the work Senza Titolo to guarantee its transmission to the future. Thank you very much.